me coming to Pakistan, I did a photo review of this, not the actual suit review. And this was a hit by so many customers. I think I must have taken like 7 or 8 orders for stitching in this. I'm happy to show you what the suit is like. It's a jasmine iris collection. Okay, and it's an absolutely beautiful design, 1065. Normally we sell these. There's actually three designs in this, three different replica versions of this. This one, they range from £15 to £18 to £20. So each one is slightly different. Now the shawl with this is a soft wool shawl. A beautiful feel to it because these are winter suits, so they come with not the chiffon dupattas but with stoles with light chadars. So that's the chadar. It comes with black linen plain trousers. The linen is absolutely beautiful. I know lots of viewers have requested to have these pre-shrunk prior to getting them stitched. If you want that service, we do charge £1 extra, and I normally hire local ladies who are quite poor to get that job done for me, which I think is worth it because in a way I feel that that is a sadaqa. And you never know when a sadaqa is going to come handy. And I'll tell you a little story recently, what's happened to us, and also make you really aware of when you're around children and so on, how careful to be. So it's a two-thingy story that I want to share with you. I always believe in giving to charity, giving to the poor, and helping the poor as well. Wherever I go, I try and make it a special, give a little bit special, take time out to do as much as I can, especially for family and so on who are not so well off, or who may have, I have family who have children who are disabled, so I do as much as I can for them. I mean, alhamdulillah, last time I came I bought a walker for one of my nephew's sons who is severely disabled, and he cannot walk. So I bought that walker for him, and alhamdulillah he was running around in that walker, but then he's grown up and his legs sort of like bent because it was too short for him. So this time when I've come, what I've done is made the effort. I actually advised him on how to get that fixed. Unfortunately, people here in Pakistan are not very active. So they don't actually, they have no vision, they have no sense of how to do things, and sometimes you have to really push them, and if you can't push them, you have to go around and do it yourself. So I'm a do-it-yourself person, and I don't believe in, you know, stories or lazying around and saying this cannot be done. If something needs to be done, I will do my best to get that done. So alhamdulillah, when I came down this time, I took that walker apart, I brought it to Islamabad with me, I took it around to welders, I sat with the welders, showed them exactly what to do, and I got that fixed, and that for me gave me so much pleasure. I mean, it cost me a little bit of money, it cost me a lot of time, because running around here, in, especially in places like Sadr, is nightmare. I'm telling you, it's so bad. Islamabad, alhamdulillah, is good, but going around in Pindi itself is absolutely awful. The traffic, the congestion, too many people, too many, oh God, no sense at all. So it's been time consuming, but it was worth it because I managed to get that fixed for the boy, and I took it back to the village, a 7-day backup, and he has taken the benefit. The reason why I mentioned that is because some of us are able to help someone with our physical interaction, while others have the ability to give a little to help the poor. So where we can give, even if it's a pound, even if it's a 50 pence, you know, for us to buy a suit like this is nothing, but for someone who is in that position where they have very little means of earning their livelihood, then this is ideal for them, because that pound works out a lot. Now I'll tell you the reasons why I like to give that pound is because sometimes with these suits, on the back of this, you'll have like little, not paper, interfacing, the right name for it. Use the right name for things, Inaya. My helper here today is my granddaughter, Inaya, who is my future inheritor of Dilpasand Libas and Jan Sewing Solutions, inshallah. So what I was talking about, I get distracted and I go into other topics. So basically what you have on suits like this is like paper backing and so on. I hired the local ladies to actually clear away all the threads, any little bits and bobs, and clear away all this paper, pre-shrunk the press. And if there's some, the other problem that you have with suits like this is sometimes they're faulty and we don't notice the faults. But if somebody is pre-shrinking these and if they're pressing them, then whilst doing that, they will notice the faults. So this is ultimately in preparation for you to get the garment, you are getting a perfect garment. Sometimes we pre-shrink these and the color loses. If that happens, what we do is we replace it and we tell the customer that there's fault with the fabric and is the color is giving. So we don't tend to send that out, because once you had it stitched, the cost goes higher. Once you send it to the customer, the price even goes higher. So what I want to avoid is I want to avoid extra charges on the sewing. So if you've pre-shrunk something and the fabric has destructed or it's become faulty, then at least there's no added cost of having this stitched, sent out to the customers, courier charges and so on. So you eliminate that and ultimately the customer is satisfied. That's basically what we're trying. Our aim is to get the customer satisfaction. So that's my motto, inshallah. I have worked so hard over this last year with trying to fit all this in with my studies. I have absolutely dedicated my life to two things. One is obviously my ilm, which I try and pursue. And secondly, to try and get the customer interaction, customer satisfaction, and to try and give motivation and skills as much as I can. So we were talking about sadqa. This is going to be a slightly longer, lengthy video because I want to, since we're on that topic, I want to talk about sadqa itself as well. Sadqa is something that you give and it comes back to you sometime when you least expect it. But for you to realize this, you really have to ponder. And you should really be thinking all the time that this must be, you know, sometimes calamities happen and you never know what you did in your life to save you from that calamity. And I'll relate an incident with you. I have a grandson, he's called Noman, and he's my little angel. Everybody in the family loves him. Everybody in the family loves him to bits. He was born with, I remember quite recently, one of my viewers contacted me because I had relayed this story in one of my previous videos quite a long time ago, where when he was born, when he was conceived, the doctors had told my daughter-in-law that this child is going to have problems. So the problems they, when she had the initial scan, the problems that they noticed was the baby only had one kidney which was functioning, and they sort of warned her of certain problems and disabilities and so on. Now it's a lengthy story which I probably covered in one of my previous videos, but during that pregnancy, the problems that she had and the fear that she had was absolutely enormous. You know, when the doctors tell you that your child may be born with disabilities, it actually sends shivers down the spine of parents. And she was so fearful. I remember my son, he was so upset. And Alhamdulillah, you know, I can't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enough of how merciful he was to us, because when this child was born, he was absolutely normal. There was, apart from the little problem with the kidney, which is actually not noticeable at all, he is an angel. Anyway, he is a little bit hyperactive, and what he does is he has a tendency to pick things up and put them in his nose. So we've come to Pakistan, and basically the other day, a few days ago, what he's done is he's picked up some tissue and he's gone and put it in his nose, and then it's been irritating him, and he was crying. And we sort of noticed that there was something wrong with him. We took him to the local doctor. The local doctor had a look. He took out a very small amount of tissue, but that didn't settle the baby. He was still crying a lot. He was very moody. He was developing a temperature and so on. So we were all quite disturbed. Then we sent him, his dad came home and we sent him and his mom to the city. And as soon as they got to the city, they had him x-rayed. And what they noticed was he's picked up one of those, you know, battery cells that you use in watches and so on, the round ones, the lithium round ones. He's gone and placed that in his nose, and it's lodged between his upper part of the nose. So the doctor has done an x-ray, he's noticed this, and then he's taken it out. He's taken him, you know, it was a painful procedure, but he's had that removed, his nose was bleeding, he came back home, he gave him some antibiotics and so on. And I'll tell you that when we realized what had happened, I cannot express, I mean, even our little ones were crying at what had happened. Inaya was crying his eyes out, Ismail was so upset, and you can imagine what, you know, instantly I was going into sajda because I could not believe, you know, when I thought about the worst consequences. I cannot thank Allah enough for us to have realized this. The reason why I mention this story to you is because always be wary of what your children, never take things lightly. And when my daughter-in-law had gone to the doctors, the doctor was quite furious at her, that what kind of a mother are you, that you've not noticed your son has gone and done this. And it was so dangerous, because I remember just reading quite recently where a child had swallowed this kind of a lithium battery, and it had actually radiated inside the stomach, and this child had actually passed away from this. So the point of this whole story and the rhetoric is to make you all aware that with children, never be you know, laid back. If you feel that your child is crying, over crying, or not settling, and he may possibly, children often have the habit of picking things up, putting them in their mouth, putting them in their nose. We recently I had a family friend who, the child, 8 month child, and this was a UK story, you may have read about it, you may have heard about it, and he swallowed a polythene bag which has lodged in his, not in the throat, in the air passages, and he choked to death within minutes. And the mother was just around, helicopter had arrived, lifted him, taken him to hospital, and he didn't survive. And that is just devastating. You know, the parent having to live with that is going to be hugely, I don't know, a test in itself. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved us from this test. And this, I believe, is something that maybe it was something that I had done, maybe it was something that my daughter-in-law had done, my son had done, or any of my families. My son, my grandson, he's very close, very attached to his granddad, who is also a very pious and religious person. So alhamdulillah, it was something in our doing that had benefited him and gave us our, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave our child back to us. So the whole point of this rhetoric is two topics. One, always be careful when your children are around. Always supervise them carefully and be wary of what they are putting in their mouth or in their nasal passages. And if you notice anything, then take action instantly. Secondly, always be generous and give sadaqah, because sadaqah will come handy and will help you out at a time of need. So that advice is, I hope you listen to the video carefully, and I hope you take advice from this and remember me in your du'as as well. Anyway, hold on. I haven't done the suit because I started talking away from it. Okay, we're going to do the suit as well, because this is one suit that I would recommend for you all to buy. Just the feel of this fabric is absolutely gorgeous. It's so nice and soft. The print on it is absolutely gorgeous, and the color is just absolutely stunning. So that's an embroidered work on the neckline. It comes with this embroidered patch for the daman as well. It's a full printed back as well. So a lengthy video. I hope that this video, you know what I'm going to do is, you know, these suits, I'm going to make you a special offer of buying these suits for £15, but you will have to work instantly because I'll have to order them in bulk and then try the sewing out with this suit, and I tell you, you will be blown away by our tailoring. So you would get a suit like this, £25 stitched, and I think that's a true bargain, because this is a quality brand name called Jasmine Iris, and I absolutely love this suit. I wouldn't mind having one made for myself and show you exactly what it's like. So take care. I hope you've enjoyed this long video, and you know, take some heed and take some advice from it. Take care. Bye.